Hello everyone. So today I am going to talk about some premium vectors because I get a request like how people making this kind of designs like for Amazon or Etsy, you can see. So this kind of designs or how to find this kind of design. So I am using this image as a reference. You have to search on Amazon like funny Christmas t-shirts. Shards, you will find a lots of designs like this. I am going to make a design on this one today. Ain't no laws when you drink with Santa Claus, like this design. So I was searching that design, and that is also in Etsy. And you can see this is a premium kind of work. So how can people make this kind of designs or work? So for finding this kind of designs, you can use this website called yandex.com. You can upload an image here to search. And then you can see that I found this image here. This is a stock image. This is a stock image of Shutterstock. So the rule is you have to buy this image from Shutterstock, and they will give you a premium license, and then you can use this design, use this image in your design. As you can see, this is the main design. There is some text, and the ribbon is overlapping the lower part of Santa Claus. Then they are like editing this design. If you are a designer, then you can understand. Then they are hiding this part, the lower part or the belt part of the Santa Claus with some random shapes, and then using this design. And of course they buy it from Shutterstock, and so they have the premium license. So you have to work like this. You have to buy premium designs from stock sites like Shutterstock, Freepik, Vexels, whatever you want. Then you can do your make your design with that. And the freebies like us, if you cannot, I have premium Freepik. So if you cannot buy from Freepik, what can you do, or how can we make this kind of trending designs? So as you can see, this is the design. So here they are not using very much premium kind of vectors, but I'm going to make a simple designs for this niche, for this text here. And first of all, I needed to check that if this is a trademark or not. You can see this is, I searched and this is showing me a dead mark. That means the failure to respond or late response, like whoever applied for a trademark for this topic, they didn't complete it. So it is now a dead mark. And if you just, you can see the description here, sweaters, Christmas, athletic sweaters, crew neck sweaters. So these have the options for the trademark they applied. If I search like t-shirt Santa Claus shirt, it will show me like no mark here. So I can, and that one is dead, so I can work with this text here. So I'm going to copy the text from this area, then paste it here. Okay, so for before making this kind of designs, we need some vectors. So I am going to use some vectors from Freepik. Sorry, I closed the window on my browser. So I'm going to use this vector bundle from Freepik, and this is free to download. You can search like BR, you will find this vector set on Freepik. I will give you the resource on my group, of course. So I'm going to use this hand, and the plan is to make this is like a beer drinking t-shirt, just like this. But I want to keep this one as it is. Then I want another part here that will be a hand of Santa Claus. And that's how I will represent the scenario here that I am drinking with Santa Claus. So for making that, I needed a Santa Claus design, of course. So I was searching like in Clipart images. I find this one good. So I'm going to use this one. This is, you can see, personal use only image, but that's not a problem because I am not going to use the image. So here is the image in my, I am using paint.net software here. I can use Photoshop, but I prefer this software. This is easy to use. So for making, I just want this hand part of the Santa Claus, nothing else, nothing of this, just this hand part here. So I hope it will be good if you see what I am doing here. So I am selecting this white part with my magic wand tool of the paint.net, then here also, just to erase this part, because I just need the outline of the hand here. So go to effect and then go to multi threshold. You will get, okay, before that we need to select the magic wand tool and click here like this, it will erase everything that is inside the transparency. There is nothing, but it shows the problem. Okay, if I go to multi-threshold like this, I can like increase or decrease the amount of threshold I want here. So just like this, I'm keeping it something like this. Then I'm going to select my selection tool, selecting this part, copy. I'm making this a bit faster, I think, talking and doing everything. Okay, so that is good for me. I think this is okay. I could have done this by drawing just a simple lines here, but I wanted to share with you guys how you can do the things. So I'm erasing everything that I don't want here, just like this. And then of course this part also I don't want for now. Okay, so I just want this effect of the hand of the Santa Claus. So select this part, I don't need that. Now I'm going to use my curvature tool here just to make a line like this. Then for this area here, I'm going to make it like this. Okay, not like that, maybe something like this. Or maybe it will be better if I just, okay, sorry for that, if I bring in this image here, copy this one, paste it here, something like this. Then I just want to use my curvature tool to follow the curve here, pressing ESC to like stopping the curvature. Okay, that is good for me. Okay, let's not stop it here, just join them something like that so that it becomes a closed shape. You can see my that part there, and now it is a shape like this. Let's put some stroke for it, and that is good for us. I'm just going to use it something like this, but this is too much bigger than the other lines, so let's make it smaller, just like this. That is good. Now I need to select it, expand it. Okay guys, so maybe this one here I'm going to make it, just fill the areas here just like this. Okay, that is good for me. Now I'm going to select them, press shift M for the shape builder. I'm pressing alt to erase this part. Okay, I don't want to erase that part, maybe just this one. Okay, let's erase this part, no problem. Then I'm going to select my direct selection tool so that I can modify these corners from here. Okay, I don't need that part, so I just want to combine these parts together. Sorry for that. Just this one, just like this. This is the very small details, so I'm just making the outline of that Santa Claus hat and the hand. So this is easy guys, you can just draw it if you want. So that's good for me. Now this is the part, this is the regular, like this is my hand, and then I'm going to drink with Santa Claus. So this is Santa Claus hand. Let's flip it, reflect it like this. Then I need to select them to align their position, but I want it to overlap the beer glasses. I want to overlap them just a little bit, then select them, align them. So that is good. Now this is the hand of the Santa Claus, so I need to put it like this so that it looks like this is a Santa Claus hat and this is a regular hand, whoever is wearing the t-shirt. And that is the, come on man. Okay, so that is the hand of Santa Claus and this is the regular hand. So you can see this area is not looking very good. So let's do something. I'm selecting my Santa Claus hat, copy this one, then selecting this vector pack here. Then if I open the transparency for it, I can press Ctrl F. Ctrl F will paste it in front. Nothing is happening here, but don't worry, just go to Pathfinder, merge, unite. It will become a complete single shape. You can see inside the transparency, and that is hiding the parts that is on that area there. So that is good for me, I think. Then again I need to select this one, copy, then select this vector pack, open the transparency, paste in front, control F, then again follow the process, merge, unite. It will become a complete single shape, but it should be complete black. You can see, we can see the lower glass from here, but if we make it black, it will be hidden. Like complete black will make it complete transparency. And also for this area here, if I select this one inside the transparency, the big shape here, we have to make sure that it is also in black. So that is good for me. Now, as this part is being a bit longer, I can take my direct selection tool to select it like this. Then I can use my like the direct selection tool or arrow key to make it a bit longer in this side. And that is good for me. Let's make it a group together. So everything here is in group. Now I'm going to make a circle like this so that it looks like, okay, my circle is in fill. Now press Shift X for converting the fill into a stroke mode. Just like this, maybe increase the size of the stroke. So that's good for us. Now we can simply do it like, okay, I want the Santa Claus hand to be a bit more visible like this, so that it looks like a clear Santa Claus hand. Sorry for that, I am telling this hand every time. Okay, so this is the point of my graphics here. That is good for me. Now let's just Ctrl C, Ctrl F to make a copy paste in front, then make a bigger one just like that. Then I am going to take this whole text together at once. Sorry for that, I need to select the type on path tool, then click here. I am showing you guys how to modify images to make your vector, and this is not something you are going to learn from like anyone. This is from my experience. If you are good at photo editing, then you can like use your that knowledge in vector editing also. So ain't no laws when you drink with, but this should be a bit smaller, just like this, so that it, sorry for that, I need to move it a bit like this. I want to make this Santa Claus hand visible, and then keep everything in the center point, of course, at the same time, so that's a bit hard. Okay, so let's bring it down like this. I think this is a good position for my graphic right now. Now this is not looking like exactly center point, I don't know how, why. So let's, okay, so I need to select this part here, come on. Okay, maybe just like this. Okay, that is good. Then drinking with Santa Claus. This is only Claus, but I am going to make it Santa Claus, because it's really good if you are making some changes. So that's good. Double click, paste it inside. Okay, so this area I am going to make it a complete fill shape here, like I will using the clipping mask. So let's select our ellipse here, copy this one. Then I'm going to select our this vector group also, right click, make a clipping mask. It will be mask out like this, but this area is looking like open area. So let's press Ctrl F. It will paste our that ellipse again in the place, and the area is hidden and it is looking good. So that is good for me. Now I'm going to, okay, so for this area I can simply select this text, Ctrl F, C, Ctrl C, Ctrl F to reflect the position like this. Then I'm going to change the base position here like this, so that I can write it inside the area here. So let's type in here Santa Claus. Is it CLAUS or okay, Okay, so Santa Claus is the spelling, that's good. Now for this one here, I'm going to make it a bit bigger because this is the focus point of my text. Then change the base point just like this. Okay, that is good for me, I think. Now I need to, like, this is a very simple kind of designs right now, and then I need to make it like a little more premium work. So beers are always, beer look good with the barley or the wheat, I don't know what it calls. So we can use some of them, but let's not do that. Let's make it simple. So the area is inside the shape is looking like a little empty. So let's do something for that. I'm going to just draw a line here. Then press Shift X for making it a stroke. Okay, it was in fill mode, so that's why I'm pressing Shift X for making it in a stroke mode. Just check if it is in fill mode or a stroke mode. Let's use this option here. So you can see we have a just like a triangle kind of shape. Okay, that is good for us. This is now in a stroke, so let's expand it. Now it becomes a fill. So that part is there, good. Now I am making another copy in this part, then rotate it like this. Then maybe I need to bit just like this, then select this to align it center wise, then make it a group. Ctrl G, then click on this rotate tool here, then press Alt and click here. It will open up this dialog box. Then if the preview is checked, you can press Shift and scroll your mouse wheel. It will look like this, like giving us a preview. So let's copy this one option and then press Ctrl D. Keep pressing Ctrl D, it will keep making copies of that shape. So that is good for us, I think. Okay, I'm sorry for that. We need to make it like more close to each other. So let's do it again. Ctrl Alt click, then I'm going to increase it like 5 points. That is good. Copy. Now press Ctrl D. Keep pressing Ctrl D so that it fills the entire area. And now once it is done, I can select this one, then making it a group together, make it smaller like this, cut. Then I need to select this hand group here. Then press, okay, maybe I can click once more so that I can select it like this. Then press Ctrl B. Okay, sorry for that, it will be pasted in the same place where it was. So let's bring it inside here in our circle area just like this. Then maybe make it a bit smaller so that it fits into the entire circle here just like this. I am just making it manually. Okay, that is looking good. Now I need to select everything here like this except this sun ray effect here. Now my bear and hand effect is selected. Now for this time I am going to make a offset path. So that is too much. So let's make it maybe 5 pixels is good. Press OK, press Ctrl X to cut. Now selecting this sun vector here, then opening the transparency, click here, then press Ctrl F. It will be pasted in the front, but you can see the sun is visible through our vector and we don't want that. So let's use the merge and unite tool to make it a complete one single shape, and that will hide the, and of course we should check that if it is a complete black, or you can see this is not complete black, so that's why we can like see the things through here. Okay, that's not a problem. If I double click here, it will show me that it is complete black or not. If it is something like this, it will be visible from the area, but make sure it is complete black. So that is good. Then once it is done, click the transparency, click on this layer here, and you will be on the surface layer, and right click, exit isolation mode. You can see we are out of the transparency, and now it is looking like this. The VR vector, the sun is making it like a busy vector here. So okay, sorry for that. this part is not looking very good, so let's cut this one. Then I'm going to paste it here, something like this. Then this text here, we are using here 120 points, so let's select that one. Let's make it 120, that one also 120, so that is good. Now I'm going to select this copy, paste in front. As you can see, now I'm making it a little bigger. Okay, so once it is bigger, I can make it smaller like this. Then I'm going to take my this text, cut. If I double click here, it will be selected, then press V to paste it here. Now this one here, we need to make it 120 pixel, just like this. And this is, I think, looking better than before. So that is, we can add some more elements here, like the, okay, let's do that. That is what I wanted to share here. So let's make a ellipse like this, just like this maybe, then make a copy here. I shared this with you in many of my videos. I'm using Shape Builder, sorry for that. Press Shift M for Shape Builder, then press Alt to erase this part, and then you have two different shapes here, just like this. Place it together, just rotate like that, then this one also like this. Or you can just simply keep one and then reflect that one, that will work for you. So let's keep one here. This is going to be the barley or the wheat effect we are going to make here, so that is good. Let's group it. Once that is in group, let's make a copy here like that, then press Ctrl D. It will keep making some groups like this, some copies like this. Then we need to select it, make it smaller so that it fits in the area, and that is good size for us. I'm using my brush tool here to make a like a pattern brush here. You can see this option here. Okay, let's not use the pattern brush, it will not be necessary. We can simply do it. So let's reflect this one, make it a smaller, just like this. And if you think this is going to fit in the area, that size is good. Now press Ctrl Z to make it a group. Now we can simply like make it a art brush here, so that it follows the curve of the shape here. I am selecting this ellipse here. Ctrl C, Ctrl F for pasting in front. So we have two shapes now. Let's make it a little bigger so that it comes in the center point of the text like this, something like that. So that is good for us. Then use the add anchor point tool. Okay, in this area I need my rulers, because I am going to make it exact same size for both area, just like this. This tool will work for me, but we need to like right click here to lock the guide. Now I need this add anchor point tool, so I can simply click here and then click here again. Of course I am clicking on the guide, and that is why I locked that guide, because if that was not locked, I was not able to click on the guide. So once my four click is done, let's select our direct selection tool to select this point, erase that, then select this point, erase that. So that is good. Now I'm going to unlock my guides, I don't need them anymore. Okay, so I think this is a bit bigger. Let's make a smaller copy here, make another, let's make it a pattern brush, just like this. And let's see which one works good. So this is going to be the first ellipse here, select that one, press here, it will be filled with that wheat or barley shape we made. I think this is looking good. Let's select this one and use the pattern brush and see which one is looking good. I think the pattern brush is looking better than this one, so let's delete that one. I am going to make it a little bigger so that it fits in the area here, just like this. Okay, then I need to expand it, because that is a brush right now. Now if I rotate like this, okay, I don't know why I did all this. I could have simply make it with the, okay, this will help you understand the brush at least. So let's make it a bit smaller, just like this. Okay, sorry guys, let's do it again. So once we have two shapes here, the part of the ellipse here, let's fill that with the pattern brush. Then this one here, fill it with the pattern brush again, but this is not following for the, like this is not following the same direction I want to make it follow. So let's select our pattern brush, make a copy here. Okay, sorry for that. Let's select this one. Then again, make another pattern brush. We can change the direction of this pattern brush, but that is not something I am going to do here. It is just simpler than that. So this is the final design for us, guys. I think this one is looking better than before. So let's add some colors here. So once our design is completed like this, I'm going to keep a copy here so that if I need any changes, I can do that. So that's what I do every time. Let's expand everything that is inside our design here. So font, effect, everything is now expanded. Now for this area here, I wanted to put some colors in the Santa Claus hat. So what we can do simply is we can take a rectangle tool here, then make it something like beer color, then cut, select this group here and this group here, press Ctrl B, it will be pasted in the background of that hand and the beer effect here. So that is good. Let's use it like this. Okay, let's select them everything together. Press Shift M for Shape Builder. You can see if I press Alt, I can click here to erase the extra part that I don't want. Now if you want, I wanted to make it like, if I select this part here, I can press K for the Live Paint Bucket tool. Then if I select here the white, I can fill it with white. Then the red here, I'm going to make it this red for the hand here, because I wanted to represent this as a, as the Santa Claus hand. So that is good for us. Now I am selecting this two vector group, then pressing K again for the Live Paint Bucket tool. Let's use something like some skin colors, maybe. I don't know how it will look. Okay, that is erasing, like destroying the effect we created earlier. So that is not the way we are going to do it. Let's double click here. So once our this shape is selected like this, we can, okay, press K for the Live Paint tool again, then go for that color again, just like this. Okay, that was not the color, maybe that one. I can fill it like this, only the area that I want it to be filled in that color. Okay, that area is not looking good. So maybe this one, just like this. Okay, as you can see, this part is a separate part, so that's why that is working like that, but that is not a problem, it will be fixed. So once that part is done, okay, we have some extra area here. That also, that one is also done. If I double click here, okay, we need to do it again like before using the, I need to first of all cut this part. Then if I select the vector here, press K for Live Paint, pressing Alt to sample that color, then fill the area, fill this one, or whichever color I want to fill it with the skin color. So that is good for me. Then once it is done, I can press Ctrl F for pasting that in front, and it should be on, it will be on top of the hand there. So that is good for me, and I should have done this in the first place, then I didn't. Now I need to do it like for the Santa Claus hand again, but if I did it first, then it was not necessary to do it. Okay, so let's do that again. Maybe this one was causing some problem. So let's select this one, cut it, select the vector, press K for the Live Paint Bucket. Click here to sample that one. Then I am filling it with the colors here. You can skip this process, guys. You don't need to do this or was this like the this process. So let's press Ctrl F for pasting that part in front. So that's some like small details make changes in the design. So that is good for us. Then for this area here, this two should be the barley color here. Let's make it that color. Then this drink one, I am going to make it white. This one I am going to make it red because this is a Santa Claus design. Okay, this is white, so this one should be red. That's good for me. Now for this one, maybe I am going to use this color. For this part also I am going to, okay, I need to select this part, this vector packs here, then press I for eyedropper. If I click here, that will be like that will be the yellow color. Now let's take a black shape in the background. So I get a question like what I did and I get a black background for my design. So I'm not doing anything very secretive. I'm just taking a rectangle here in black color and that is on top of my design, so it is not visible. Let's press Ctrl X for cut that shape. Now if I want to paste that shape like behind anything, then I have to select that. So I'm going to select all of this and then pressing Ctrl B, it will be pasted on the in the background and in the exact same place. So you can see now this is like this is the final design for us, and I am really happy because this was just an idea to make it look like a Santa Claus hand, to represent like I am drinking with Santa Claus, and this is really looking good, guys. So we have some problem here. As you can see, this part of the hand should be also in that color. So I'm selecting this one, pressing K, sampling that color, filling it with that. So that is good. That one is fixed. Now again, click here to select this. I'm clicking on the black to select the blacks only. You can see if I press Ctrl X, the black only will be cut out. So let's not do that. Press K for the light paint, press here, then fill it with that color. So that is good for me. I think this one will give you some idea for how you can make this kind of graphics, or you can modify vectors to make a design. So thank you guys, that's all for today's video. Thank you everyone, see you in the next one. Have a great time.